This episode's FTR shoutout goes to Hilo the Hamster. Leave a comment down below to have a chance for a shoutout in the next episode. Make sure you're subscribed. Hey guys, I'm actually not feeling too good today. Just kidding, I'm always feeling good. Ha 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 ha. For those of you who are still watching, welcome back to another Fish Tank Review.
I am so telling mom, stop that! Stop that right now! I am telling mom, that is my fish tank, George! You're not a fish! Get out of my fish tank!
Review. Just kidding, guys. I'm doing fine. No, seriously, I am doing fine. But I know for sure that in the comment section, there'll be people who are like, no, Chris is lying. He's actually depressed. You guys just care about me so much. Oh, I'm touched. All right. Just when life's throwing you around, when you can't get a good grasp on life, that's all these fish right now. I forgot who sent it to me. I'm sorry. But whoever the post was, or whoever sent it to me, claimed that this person is a self-proclaimed fish lover. Yeah, get that. Wrap that around your head. Let's watch it again. Self-proclaimed fish lover. Someone who loves fish is doing that right now to their fish. Let's address the elephant in the room. Pretty obviously this is a breeder, because there's a lot of fish and they all look kind of the same, with kind of the same colorations. And this reminds me of this one comment that really pissed me off. You know how people are like, don't let the haters get to you. This guy, man, below one of my betta fish videos, I think it was a video about Rosé, the guy was like, dude, this fish is so low grade, and in my country, our fish are so much more beautiful. This fish is nothing. Like, you suck. Throw that fish away. It's not even, like, it's worthless. Bro, there's a big difference in why I keep fish and why you keep fish. Don't get me wrong, there's a whole bunch of breeders out there that are amazing, but some of the breeders, I mean, they're just really breeding because they want to make the best looking betta fish. Or the best looking whatever. Maybe it's easier to understand if I use dogs, like a purebred, pure breed English bulldog. Does that make that dog somehow better or more superior to, let's say, a mixed breed like a mutt? Like, not even mixed breed of two, like you can't even tell what this dog is. Does that really make your purebred English bulldog better than the mutt just because it's purebred? Let me tell you something. Similar with betta fish and any other fish that are just bred and inbred to heck, the English bulldog cannot even breathe properly after a few years of its life. I would rather have my pet be as healthy as it can be instead of looking pretty. I don't know how pretty it is to have a nose that's basically flat and can't breathe properly, but some people find that attractive, I guess. Same thing with fish, especially the males. All the male betta fish at your big chain pet store, man, they will really struggle in about 5 months. The dragon scales will go blind. All of the half moons, all of the crown tails, all of the longer finned bettas will start struggling to swim. That is why I never get male bettas anymore. I only get females or placats. Anyways, I just went on a huge rant. Let's continue on. Corridors when the water temp drops by 1 degree. Let's get it on. Yeah, man, Cory Cats, they're just out to mate, out to breed. When the weather gets cold, looking for something to rhyme. That's kind of an innuendo. Not working out. I'm not a rapper. Found this at a friend house. Very awkward, always awkward, especially when you go over to a friend's house and they have something like that going on in their house. I mean, what is that? That is an oversized wine cup. Some dude selling lamps sent me this as a demonstration. When you're trying to sell a lamp, but then you get outed as a fish abuser. What is happening here? This is a limited edition aquascape that I've never, ever seen before. Not even on all the years of FTR. Has it been years? Anyway, palm trees? Plastic palm trees? Really? Okay, I guess that's what we're going with. This is a tank sent by Lily Carlisle. I think I've reviewed one of your tanks before, but this might be an update. Endlers with the betta. Nice. I love the tiger lotus. You're keeping it short. That's one option, and perfectly works. The other Tiger Lotus, you're keeping it tall, you're making it go up to the surface. It's such a versatile plant. I love Tiger Lotus and I need to get myself some Lotus. I've been saying that for a while. Definitely not in agreement with your substrate. Of course, you already know that. The hardscape is pretty nice. You've got a sort of ratio going on, not sure what, but it does look pleasant, so that's not bad. 3.95 out of 5, keep it up. This tank is sent in by Ocean Navarro. Now, when your name is literally ocean, your parents are super cool for naming you that. Cute little guppy tank, very understocked. The hardscape is okay, it's just a pretty linear scape. Java fern looking real healthy. Blue background, so pretty clean overall. All right, 3.85 out of 5, keep it up. Someone bought some floaters from me yesterday and sent me this follow-up pic. That's nice. I explained to her why this was bad and she is working on setting up a 5-gallon tank for this guy now. There is hope. Ooh, yeah. Oh, wow. I'm so glad they actually listened to you. Another exposed person just trying to show the floaters in the tank, but then learned something very beneficial for themselves and for their crown-tail betta. Nice. I'm so glad you educated that person and I'm so glad they are someone who actually can take some constructive criticism. That's kind of rare nowadays. This tank is sent in by Frida from Sweden. Much love to Sweden. Beautiful betta, short fin. I think it might be placat. Very nice. My favorite thing's gotta be that little trail you made. However, the very dark colors of those really blunt looking stones in the back are, to me, kind of throwing off the balance in this tank. I mean, some people can make it happen, but a pro tip in aquascaping is to keep all the hardscape materials semi-close to the same, if not the same. So an Oko Stone hardscape, keep it Oko Stone, don't mix Seiru, don't mix Lava Rock, other stones. The whole tank just to the betta itself, keep it up. 4 out of 5. This tank is sent in by Rachel Williams. Big angels, looking very healthy, got a pretty nice size of a tank. I would guess maybe it's somewhere between 30 to 40 gallons, which is acceptable for a couple angels. And you got a albino Cory in the back? Probably a few of them. Good job. Hardscape is nice. The background looking a little artificial and there's a bit of glare, so I can't tell exactly what's the glare and what's the background, but yeah, there's also a little artificial thing, a little boat, but it could have sentimental value and I'm not gonna judge. Fish look healthy and yeah, keep up the good work. 3.9 out of 5. If I'm not wrong, there is a platy in it. By the way, you guys hate the way I say platy. I mean, sure, platy. I'll try to say platy from now on. I am taking your constructive criticism. How small would that be? It would be literally like this small, maybe even less water volume. That's crazy. I hope it is just for show. Even if it is, again, not great because people will try to copy this and think it's okay. Even though this guy's doing it for show. That's why y'all gotta stop defending those people who are like, hey man, this guy, who I will not name anymore, put this fish in just to show it on video and then they took it out. So what? That has the same effect if he or she didn't take it out. So that is not an excuse. There is no excuse. Just don't do it. This tank is sent in by Shu and they are from New Zealand. What up, 3 Mickey Mouse platies. I only know they're called Mickey Mouse platies because I used to work at a big chain store that had these. Or else I wouldn't have known they are the Mickey Mouse variant. They are called that because of the Mickey Mouse shaped black spot very close to their tail. It's like a trio of platies. Platy gang, nice. I just want to keep saying the word platy over and over again so I can get that in my head. It took me a while, I used to say beta. Yeah, imagine that. The scape is pretty simple. Again, make sure that your substrate is fertilized because those plants tend to be pretty heavy root feeders. I see a sword in the back and they're notorious for just jacking all the nutrients in your substrate. So make sure that's happening. 4 out of 5, keep going. This tank is sent in by Mental Gentleman, which is a very cool name and a very cool tank. Ooh, I really like it. Oversized hardscape is the best hardscape in my opinion. And you got these nice looking rocks. I really dig the hardscape and I love that you embedded all these plants right in the middle. I'm not sure what kind of fish or what kind of tetra that is. UNS tank, ADA competitors, love the light. I really want to get myself a tank like this. Keep it up, you're doing an amazing job. 4.7 out of 5. A very famous Instagram account's sorority. I'm so disappointed in her. Usually it's beautifully obfuscated. But four females in a 7-gallon cube with no hiding spaces even when the decor is in. So many people will try this because they saw her do it. My point exactly. The more famous you are, the more responsibility you have to keep things proper. And this ain't proper. Four females, which is an even number, which shouldn't really be happening. It's not a good idea to put even number fish because then they can't properly distribute their pecking order, especially when they are semi-aggressive fish like female bettas in a 7-gallon. Now, betta sororities, I would suggest a 20-gallon minimum for 3 or 5 to start. But if you really ask for my opinion on this, I don't really support betta sororities because the risk is just always there and they're always going to have some ripped up fins. It's never going to be perfect in there and you're always going to have to wake up and kind of pray that all your fish are still there. That's no way to keep a fish tank. Beginner planted tank. Expectation. Oh man, that is a 6 out of 5, dude. Reality. Well, hey man, it's not bad. It's not that bad. It is reality though, I'll give you that. But actually, my first few tanks look even worse than that. So guess what? The expectation is also in reality. Someone made that. And that someone, I mean, he may as well be a genius, but doesn't have to be. There are a lot of people who can make tanks that look like that. And they're not all, you know, they don't all have superpowers. They're all just like us, human. Just like Tony Stark, if he's able to make Thanos bleed, everybody realizes Thanos is still able to be defeated. No spoiler alert, because if you haven't watched it by now, hey man, it's not my fault, come on. My betta fish is looking kind of weird. Is he okay? Are you okay? You get some glasses. Just get some Melafix, should be fine. Betta in an as seen on TV tank with Bender Ruse inside as decoration. What in the world am I looking at? Oh, this? Is this one of the first editions of the Gravity Flow 2 series? By David and his friend, and they're both high. If you guys haven't watched that FTR episode, highly suggest it. It's become a meme on this channel. Gravity Flow 2. Get it now. Never do a water change again, can. And then they threw in some pipe cleaners. I remember pipe cleaners. And then they were like, okay, this is a good tank for a betta. Electric eel? Manual eel. I get it. That's funny. We're ending off on a meme. Yay. Perfect. Great. Love it. Thank you guys for tuning in the whole way, pushing the video out, using the algorithm of the magical YouTube space. Can't be here without you guys. I am so thankful. I hope you guys are having a wonderful week. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe. There'll be more videos to come in the future, near future, as in like in 2 days, Wednesday and then Friday. See you guys there. And don't forget to get your hands wet.